Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 747, and today's topic is the medicinal importance of cocaine alkaloid part 2, and I am discussing the coca leaves alkaloid, and the main constituent or the most important one is that is called cocaine, which is having lot of medicinal importance. And in the last lecture I have already discussed and that's why I am discussing detail its nucleus, because to know only about the cocaine is alkaloid is not enough for pharmacy and chemistry students. They should understand the type of nucleus present. So yesterday I have already explained that there are tropene, or we can also call it tropane alkaloids, the group of alkaloids, and this tropene alkaloids, actually tropane alkaloid, what they are mentioning means it is 5-member tropane ring which contains nitrogen with methyl group, that is called tropane. And any alkaloid which contain this 5-member nitrogen containing methyl group ring is called tropane alkaloid, and that is also called tropene, and chemically I am going to discuss it. So that's why it is called tropane group of alkaloids, and mainly they are from solanaceae family, that's why they are called solanaceous alkaloids, and also they are found in coca leaves, so they are also called coca alkaloids. And when we are talking of coca alkaloid, mainly it is cocaine. So the cocaine is the nucleus of tropene alkaloid, and this tropene is 5-member ring which contains nitrogen, and that nitrogen is linked with methyl group. All these tropenes or tropane alkaloids, there must be methyl group in their nitrogen in 5-member ring, and once hydroxy group is there at 3 position, then it is called tropene, and then this one is converted into eugenine alkaloid, and that eugenine alkaloid that is acidic form, that is converted into ester of eugenine alkaloid, is called actually cocaine. So cocaine is nothing but it is that eugenine, and that is the mixture of racemic mixture of plus and minus, that is levo and dextro, and mainly it is actually levo form which is pharmacologically or biologically active. So all these explanations are given here in the structures. So the medicinal importance of cocaine alkaloid, and that is commonly called cocaine, and the cocaine possesses the tropene nucleus, and this is your tropane nucleus, and this tropane nucleus is 5-member ring, and where nitrogen is containing one methyl group, CH3 is methyl group, and this nucleus is the main nucleus in cocaine, that is tropane nucleus. And once there is hydroxy group at 3 position, and we can count here like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and once there is hydroxy group at 3 position, then it is called tropene. And it is bicyclic system made up of 5-member ring, and in that 5-member ring, that is one after one, there is nitrogen, and after nitrogen there is 5 carbon, and after 5 carbon there is 6 and 7. So in that case you can see this is 5-member ring, and which is containing nitrogen with methyl linkage. In this nucleus, the nitrogen is always methylated, means nitrogen is always having CH3 group. The 3-hydroxy derivative of tropane is called tropene. So once at 3 position of that 5-member ring, there is hydroxy group, then it is called tropene, otherwise it is called tropane, and that's why the name of this group of alkaloids are called tropane or tropene alkaloids. The 3-hydroxy derivative of tropane is known as tropene. Esterification of tropene with tropic acid yields have thy mind, have thy mind, and that have thy mind is called tropine. Tropine is a type of ester, and that ester is cocaine. So what is tropic acid? Tropic acid is this, where in this five-member ring, that is tropine, there is a benzene ring and CH2OH, and this star means this carbon in this tropic acid is asymmetric. Asymmetric or chiral atom means it is not symmetrical, different type of groups are attached, like benzene group is attached, hydroxy group is attached, then carbonyl group is there, that's why this carbon became asymmetric. So hydroxyamine is the pure optical isomer of atropine, and that atropine, once it is in isomeric form, that plus and minus, minus means Leo, plus means dextro, and that is actually the mixture of Leo and dextro of hyoscyamine. And this hyoscyamine mixture, that is called this mixture is called hyoscyamine tropine, and the coca leaves contain the racemic mixture of hyoscyamine. This is your racemic mixture, and actually hyoscyamine is nothing but it is mixture of tropine into Leo and dextro form. That is the real inside nucleus of cocaine, what cocaine is. And then that mixture and the coca leaf contain the racemic mixture of hyoscyamine alkaloid, and that is 1%. And have the same tropane nucleus called egonine. So this egonine is, and this is finally converted to cocaine. So egonine nucleus, this is your egonine, and this egonine is actually it is called cocaine. And this egonine is containing here COH, and once it is having COH, it is called egonine. And once R means, if it is converted into ester, and that esterification gives the compound of that egonine acid, that is called cocaine. So this is actually where R can be benzoic acid, R can be cinnamic acid. And these acids, when they are converted into ester, it is, after esterification, it is powerful cocaine alkaloid, and which has lot of biological and pharmacological importance, and it acts on our central nervous system, and it can activate, it can stimulate, and it has lot of narcotic effect. So now I'm discussing here how the coca leaves are processed by Peru and Bolivian people, I mean the farmer who are cultivating, and all detail I have given. And finally they prepare, they are highly skilled in processing of these coca leaves, because it is their product they are cultivating, and then it is sent to or exported to Colombia. And actually Colombia is the main center. Colombia is the main center of pure cocaine. And lot of political tension or issues are there with, I mean, that is South American country and North America, because of the processing plants and laboratories, well-established laboratories to process, to purify and to synthesize the cocaine. And the paste of the coca leaves are supplied by those countries, Peru and Bolivia, that is Bolivia. Number one, coca is very ancient plant. It has long history of its use. It's ancient plant, and they were knowing about its central nervous system stimulant and brain stimulant, and also they were using in most many of the South American countries, and where it is very high altitude from 2,000 feet to 6,000 feet hilly area, where the water is drained. Actually, it is cultivated exactly in the same way, in the same type of soil, drained soil at high altitude, like tea plantation. And the leaf and all those also, they look like tea plantation, but of course they are rich in cocaine alkaloids. And coca shrubs grow in the situation similar to tea plantation, and the coca plant is cultivated in a well-drained soil at an altitude of 2,000 to 6,000 feet, and from second year, actually it takes 2 years to get mature, and within 2 years time you will be having enough coca alkaloids manufactured in leaves. So after 2 years time, the plucking or cutting of leaves is started. Second year, the leaves are collected usually 3 times in a year. So after every 4 months, this cutting is done. So we can say we can get 3 crops out of plant, coca plant, in 1 year. And collect from second year, the leaves are collected usually 3 times in a year, and is dried in shade. Of course, it is dried under shade, because once you are drying under sunlight, there will be some damage of the organic compounds. That's why it is advisable to dry it under shade. And the leaves are usually used by natives, and those natives are Peru and Bolivia. Peru and Bolivia, these two countries are the center of the production of coca leaves, and they are given permission, legal permission, by international community to grow for pharmaceutical use. And they are using locally the natives for chewing, and remaining leaves are exported. Actually, up to 30% they are chewing, and some they are chewing by adding some lime, calcium hydroxide, so that it is more powerful. So with that they are using. And number two, crude alkaloid of coca leaves are exported, and the mixture of alkaloids are hydrolyzed to egonine. And egonine, I have already given the structure, and I have given the all explanation of egonine. Egonine is the nucleus of cocaine, and egonine is nothing but is the isomeric mixture of tropine and propane, isomeric form. That is whole chemistry and chemicals of cocaine, that is hydrolyzed to egonine, and from this cocaine is synthesized with benzoic acid. Peru and Bolivia are the only two countries authorized under international agreements to grow coca plant legally for pharmaceutical uses. These two countries are the main source of cocaine. Actually, these two countries are the main source of cocaine, in the sense that they are cultivating, because they are given legal license by international community, and it is purified and synthesized in the laboratories and in coca plants, that is in Colombia. And there are about 30% of harvested leaves are consumed by the local people who chew the coca leaves, and approximately 3% is exported legally. So you can imagine that whatever they are producing, 97% they are using illegally for pharmaceutical use and purposes. Only 3% are coming legally to pharmaceutical industries for medicinal purpose, to use as anesthesia in cancer, as a painkiller, and in surgical wards as anesthesia, and also in dentistry for local anesthesia. All these, only 3%, rest of the 97% are just manipulated, and it goes illegally here and there. That is the serious issue globally. that is only 3% is exported in a legitimate commerce for manufacture of cocaine for pharmaceutical uses. Number three, in the processing of the coca leaves to final product cocaine, farmers themselves are skilled. All those farmers who are cultivating, they are highly skilled to prepare its paste. And once the paste is prepared, that paste is supplied to Colombia for final production of cocaine. Skill and they first convert coca leaves into coca paste, which is transported to Colombia to synthesize pure cocaine. So number four, between 150 to 200 kg of dried coca leaves is needed for to make 2.5 kg of coca paste. And this 2.5 kg of coca paste can give up to 1 kg of pure cocaine in pure form. The coca paste is acidified and aqueous layer is separated and made alkaline with ammonia or baking soda, which precipitate the thick aromatic compound containing cocaine and other alkaloids. So that thick aromatic compound, that peculiar aromatic, that is aroma or smell, and because of that peculiar aroma and smell, the cocaine, when anybody is carrying at airport or railway station or bus stand, anywhere, it can be detected because of that peculiar aroma. It's very strong characteristic aroma of cocaine. And number five, the smoking of coca paste, actually this is a new type of, you can say, addiction. Once in Peru, Bolivia, Colombia, and another Ecuador, these countries, they are very expert, I mean the farmers who are cultivating, to make the paste. And once paste is prepared, means it is of course impure form, but mainly 1 to 1.5% cocaine is there, and that is enough to give the hallucinating effect. They can activate the central nervous system. So what they are doing, they will just start using the paste itself rather than purifying it for pharmaceutical purpose. So nowadays, I mean, it is a serious issue of addiction of cocaine paste in very crude form. And all these four countries, South American, and also in America also, because they are sending thousands of kilogram of this coca paste, and also in pure form. So that is the serious issue. The smoking of coca paste has become drug abuse, and that is a serious problem in Peru, Bolivia, Colombia, and Ecuador. So these four countries are suffering today from this coca paste smoking. It's a very serious issue. This is a big business, billions of dollar business of smuggling coca paste. Once the paste, and paste, even the uneducated layman, those who are cultivating these coca leaves, they can prepare. And I have told you that from 150 to 200 kg of coca leaves, we can get 2 kg of paste. And from that 2 kg of paste, 1 kg of cocaine is purified. 300,000 kilogram of coca leaves have been imported in USA. Today's, I mean, report, the saying that up to 300,000 kilogram leaves are, I mean, we can say, have been imported. Imported means illegally it is sent to America. And out of which they are preparing paste. And the paste used, smoking paste, is also widely used in America, that's, and it is banned. It is prohibited. Lot of problem is there. Even then they are getting this much compound, I mean the leaves. And that is, it is estimated that up to 80 tons of cocaine comes into United States for illicit use. Illegal for use, and mainly it comes and it is crystallized in Colombia. That's why there is always political tension and sometimes some attack and bombing to some of the laboratories and processing plants, synthesizing and purifying laboratories in Colombia. Number six. Coca leaves contain 1 to 1.5% alkaloid, cocaine, cinnamide, cocaine, and alpha and beta toxylene. Coca alkaloids are chemically derived from the racemic mixture of tropane 3-ol, that is called tropene. I have already given the structure, that 5-member ring where with nitrogen there is a methyl group attached, and at 3 position there is alcoholic group, hydroxy group, and that one is your tropane 3-ol, that is called tropene. And this cocaine is the most important alkaloid, and it is the derivative of egonine. I have already discussed all these structures. Egonine, I have already told you that mainly it is the ester of the acid of egonine, that acidic group of egonine. Its structure is converted into ester, and that is called your cocaine ester. And cocaine and is methyl benzoyl egonine. So today I will stop here, and that is part 2, and part 3 I will be discussing tomorrow, and I will try to conclude, otherwise it may go up to part 4. And tomorrow I am going to discuss some very clear picture and structure of cocaine and their derivatives and how they are used. And I am giving lot of emphasis on this cocaine chapter because it has lot of political and social impact on global population. So with this, I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.